What I would say to Paul is I'm grateful for how genuine he was, in his objections to things, his enthusiasm for things, and his basic optimism that resulted in all this great work. The positive results of his commitment to science are going to be felt more and more over the next few years, and it is just sad that he won't be here to have witnessed that.
You know, I think in bioscience, Paul's legacy will be that he enabled us to embrace the complexity of biology and not to be fearful of it, and to actually harness that complexity to gain insight into what's actually going on in both health and disease, and to see if we can use those mechanistic insights to advance new therapies.
Having this individual generative foundation that is wanting people to go out of the comfort zone, to do something different, to really tackle big problems from in a different way. I think it's amazing. And we have far too little of it nowadays in science. We are too conservative in the way of funding science. And I think his legacy is going to be sourced for a very long time.
I think that legacy is just starting to be written. You know, I think he's created these remarkable institutes and a culture around doing high-risk transformative science. There may be things that we can point to that say, this happened because of the Allen Institute, this happened because of Paul Allen's vision. But I think by creating a culture where the highest risk, most important science is valued, that can have ramifications that are very hard to measure as directly from him and his vision, but nonetheless may be the most important consequences.
It was just visionary the way that he thought about what does the field need to move it forward. And instead of picking these tiny little problems, he picked a big problem that sort of helped everybody. As a neuroscientist, the Allen Brain Atlas has been transformational. Everybody I know uses that brain atlas.
If I think into the Middle Ages and how people were thinking about the new world and there were no maps, and kind of what is the extent of this world that we live in, I view him as a person who viewed biological science and medicine in that way. How can we look beyond the territories that we now see? How can we move forward? How can we create a cartography or a kind of structure that can help us understand what we can't even imagine?
Two things stand out for me. One is generosity, the idea that you would build and do research and immediately make it available to everybody else in a format that's user-friendly. That concept, I think, is catching on, and other people are seeing it. It's not just doing your work and, you know, getting the results and somehow putting them out there in a complicated way. It's making them available to the community. I think that's going to be a big part of what we consider to be the most important things that are resolved from this institute.
Paul has completely changed my life and my career. Right. So I think there's the support, obviously, the generous philanthropy, and then there's the support of feeling like you've just been pushed onto the, let's say, the football field, right, just for a good analogy. You've been pushed out of the football field and someone's like, here, we're giving you the ball, right? We want to see great things. So I think that's it's meant the world, really.
If it's worth doing, it should be done. It should be done well. And to be done and done well, it has to be supported at a sufficiently high level. And I think that's this kind of uncompromising attitude to discovery, right? If it's worth doing, you know, just go for it. And here's the resource to do that. And, you know, if we could multiply by 10 that vision of Paul and have, you know, 1,000 others think the same way and do the same thing, then the rate of discovery will be accelerated by orders of magnitude.
It's really critical, I think now more than ever, right, to actually believe in human ingenuity, which I do, and all it can do, and to fund that, and to fund disciplined risk takers that are willing to take on these challenges and say, you know what, it is possible, right? Nothing is possible until it is. And I think he showed that in his life. And I think science and knowledge have the potential to really continue to change things. We're nowhere near the end of our trajectory, but it needs people who have done it to fund, to believe it, and to say, why not?